Okay, without further ado, let's welcome Michael to the stage.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining my session. My name is Michał Brygidyn, and today I will tell you some stories about bad actors getting admin access on your AWS accounts. Let's start with a very simple scenario that is just HTML, but how someone can access your AWS account through HTML. Very easy, just see the source code and you can find comments. Comments in HTML or plain text credentials in JavaScript. As you can see, someone just left a profile for the credentials file here. You can see access keys, secret keys. Just grab them, use them, and you have access to someone's account. It's that easy. It gives you access for the IAM user with permissions that this IAM user has. This one was admin because it had an administrator access policy attached. But why this happened? Sensitive data left in the code. There are many other ways how you can share your credentials with other teams. There are many places where you can store your credentials for your apps. Please do not put them in the code that goes to repository, that goes to all your environments and ends up on production. Next scenario, we'll start with a public repository. This example is GitHub, and I found a lot of repositories with sensitive code inside, in config files, in some dump files, anything. Sometimes even open issues for the project, for the repository, reveal some sensitive information and credentials. As you can see, we have SMTP credentials in an issue. We have SMTP or database credentials in the code, just there for anyone to access, because these are from the open repositories, open for all on GitHub. You can just find them. But how you can get to AWS using credentials for SMTP or database? In my scenario, I found a config file with credentials for SMTP Office 365. So after checking that, it was a user for Office 365 with all licenses, including Teams. So I was able to just say hi to CTO, CEO, or whoever. And they got a message from noreply@yourcompany.com. And I was also able to check SharePoint files. And that's where I found a PDF that a team created when they were installing Jira. Every single step of the installation was in that file, including the last step. And now we created admin user. And here's the admin user email and password. So with that, I was able to log into that Jira, because it was publicly accessible, so jira.yourcompany.com. It let me in. I was super admin there, so what to do now? Look for AWS on the list of projects. And through all this, I just checked all of these projects. Some of them had tickets like, please create a user for me. One of them also had a comment. Oh, here's your access and secret key for this IAM user that you requested. And it's admin, so you don't ask us for more permissions later. That easy, admin access, starting from public GitHub repository, not even related to AWS. Linking small misconfigurations may lead someone to access your accounts. What went wrong here? First of all, starting with plain text credentials in config files. Please don't do that. There are vaults, there are secret managers, parameter stores where you can where you can safely store your passwords, access keys, etc. Also, the lack of security awareness. The team that created the PDF, first of all, they shouldn't put passwords in a PDF shared with the company. And then the PDF was also shared in a place accessible by anyone from the company. So I got access to one account, and I have access to everything that's shared with the whole company. There are two things that I want you to remember from my presentation. And the first one is MFA. Wherever possible, please force your users to use that. And force MFA, use MFA. Because if there is no MFA, and I have your username and password, I can log in, and I can do whatever I want with your user in the cloud. Next scenario starts with a PHP framework called Symfony. Do you guys use PHP? Yeah, I see two hands there. Okay. It's a framework for PHP, and it has a tool called Profiler. The Profiler tool is pretty nice when you develop an app, but if you leave it there and an attacker finds it, they can extract sensitive information like server parameters, environment variables, requests history, or even preview files from the project directory. Let's take a look at some of these files and some of this information. From environment variables, I was able to extract S3 access and secret key. But hey, I need admin. S3 is fine. I already have access to your data, but I cannot do much more than that. So let's dig deeper. Next one shows a post request to a login endpoint. So someone just tried to log into the application and put a username and password. It got logged, and Profiler showed it to me. So with that, I was able to just log in to this development environment and of that app and see what's there. But then, hey, I was a developer once, and if there is dev.example.com, there should be prod version. So I tried the same for justexample.com. Guess what? I'm in. And it was admin user. It was some internal app, and the app had many tiles there to click, and it worked like SSO. I just clicked one tile, one icon, and it opened a CRM for that company. OK, I don't need that. I clicked another one, a webmail. OK, more interesting, because in webmail, I was looking for AWS. There were many emails from AWS, like invoices, like trusted advisor. And this gave me an idea that, OK, this user, this email, maybe it's a root user email for someone's account. And then after contacting with CISO before that, I got an approval to continue my research. And the CISO said, OK, let's do that. We have some policies. We have some procedures. They should catch you before you get that far. Guess what? I was able to just reset the password for that. There was no MFA on that root user, so I logged in. And it was not just a single AWS account. It was the organizational management account with like 40 accounts there, and they were not using the identity center. They were not using SSO. So I used that for them. I enabled the SSO, created administrator permission set, and gave myself admin everywhere, because they were not using it, so I created the local user in SSO, and I was admin on all 40 accounts there. That easy. All started with a non-prod version of some PHP app. what wrong here? What went wrong here? So yeah, production data was reused. If it's not the full dump from production on non-prod, it may be just a user's table, or maybe it's just a password that was used on both non-prod and prod. Please don't do that. Use different passwords, unique passwords, and try not to remember them. Use password manager for that. Next thing, admin everywhere. The user that was there, that the user used, was admin with access to all systems there. And this email that was there in the webmail also was used to register for other tools, other external tools. So it was not only getting access to AWS, it was getting access to all their tools. And again, no MFA. Thank you for that. Easier for me. Next, we have misconfigurations in the infrastructure. Do you guys use Kubernetes? OK, I see some hands. This starts with a misconfigured Kubernetes control plane. And I was able to find hundreds of IPs with Kubernetes API, Kubernetes control planes. And with just a web browser, you can ask the API, hey, give me a list of pods. Give me a list of all config maps or secrets. Secrets are base64 encoded, so it's almost plain text. And I have a tool for that, so my tool shows me this. As you can see, there's a list of pods, running pods. I can see what's there. The namespace can give me an idea of who's the owner of that. then config maps are just the contents of configuration files that you will have on your pods, and secrets decoded already. So as you can see, S3 access from the secrets from Kubernetes, just like that. And still, no admin. but in secrets, I found Jenkins credentials. Jenkins is the automation server. And usually, when you use the automation server to do something for you, like, for example, build your infrastructure, the automation server has admin-like access to your infrastructure. So when I found admin user and password for Jenkins, next step, OK, I need to find access. I need to find a way to access this Jenkins. There are three ways to do that. Either you just try jenkins.example.com, and it worked here. Or if it's not working, then you can just forward port 8080 from that pod to your local machine and access localhost 8080, and you'll have their Jenkins on your localhost. Or just exec into the pod and run any command on bash. For me, it worked with the first solution, jenkins.example.com. And when you are in Jenkins, what you can extract from that? Starting from workspaces, every time you run a job and grab some code from repository, the code is there in the workspace. You can just browse it and extract config files or some processed files, whatever you want. Then Jenkins credentials. There are many projects with misconfigured access and with sensitive data in Jenkins credentials. And I found, for example, a GitHub access there. It's one-liner to extract the plain text value from credential in Jenkins credentials. But still, no admin access for me. So I tried to take a look at build logs, at console logs from different builds. And there were logs from AWS CLI. So I already knew that there is AWS CLI installed. So I went back to the third solution to access that and just used kubectl exec bash on that pod. It gave me a shell, so I just try AWS, S3 LS. Oh, yeah, it works. So I tried another one and another one and figured out that Jenkins has a role with administrator access, policy attached. That easy. What went wrong here? First of all, public resources. If you can hide your resources in private subnets, please do, because I asked them why they left this in a public subnet with public IP and no role-based access control. Hey, it's just a random IP. Only our team knows that. Nope, you're wrong. There are search engines scanning the whole internet, IP by IP, port by port, and indexing all responses from that. So you can just use Shodan Senses binary edge to find your open Kubernetes and extract whatever you want. Disable security features. I already mentioned no role-based access control. I don't know why they disabled that. They just did that. Second thing to remember for you today, principle of least privilege. If you give everyone admin, it's not a good idea. So please try to give your resources and users the exact permissions that they need to perform their task. Nothing more, nothing less. And there are more scenarios starting from outdated software running on cloud servers. 5 or 6 years ago, there was a bug in Atlassian products, and it was like the open proxy vulnerability. So I just found a Jira or Confluence or whatever and asked it for metadata of the EC2 that it was running on. Access key, secret key, token, thank you. I already had access to AWS on the permissions of that EC2, and the permissions were pretty high. Then logs from tools, from installation of tools. I was auditing one of my customers, started with read-only access, then found logs in CloudWatch logs from the installation of Jenkins. And similar to installation of Jira, last line, and this is login and password for Jenkins. So then I already knew that there is a public EC2 for Jenkins. I logged in, and you know the rest of the story. Next one, misconfigured virtual hosts on your web servers. That one is interesting. When you install Apache or Nginx or whatever you use, it installs the default directory, that default virtual host for that, and then you create your own virtual host for your domain. But when I access your server by IP, I can see this if you misconfigured your vhost. And .env file contains your passwords and other access keys for your other tools. Next one, debug pages from different tools and frameworks. This one is interesting. It's Python Django. And as you can see, it's pretty nice because it already masks everything that contains key or password. But please take a look at the third line from the bottom, Celery Broker URL. That one contains access key and secret key of an IAM user. It was enough to just grab that. And believe me, these credentials for just SQS were not just for SQS. Usually, they gave me a lot more access than just SQS. Thank you. That was the last slide. If you have any questions, please raise your hand. Or you can catch me on LinkedIn. This big QR code goes right to my LinkedIn. I'll be here around if you want to talk or catch me. I'm also on PeerTalk. Thank you for joining.
Thank you very much.